Welcome class. Now we are reaching towards the end of this unit and where we are going to talk about transition towards value-based life and profession. So, you know, it would be appropriate if we recapitulate the core message which we have understood throughout the discussion of the units up to now. So, the first thing is to be able to fulfill the basic human aspiration, that is happiness and prosperity and their continuity, it is essential to gain the right understanding, that is the understanding about oneself with the rest of the existence, and the understanding about continuous happiness and prosperity. So both I have to understand. This involves the realization that there is innate harmony at all levels of existence. In fact, the whole existence is coexistence. It was there already. Now we just have to be aware of it. We have to realize that it is there, and accordingly we have to work. So it becomes essential purpose of human beings to understand this harmony and coexistence and learn to live in accordance with it and be fulfilled. So only after getting this understanding about the harmony and the coexistence and then living according to it, we are going to be fulfilled. We are going to have that feeling of happiness and prosperity, and its continuity will be there in our lives. So this truth has been grossly ignored in our present worldview, whereby happiness and prosperity are perceived primarily in terms of maximization of sensory enjoyments, maximization of wealth, and accumulation of more and more physical facility. This misconception is leading to problems in all walks of life and is not conducive to sustainable happiness and prosperity. The happiness which can be continuous, the prosperity which can be continuous, cannot, you know, is going to take place with the help of the present worldview, where our focus is solely on the physical facilities. Hence, it becomes imperative, it is very much essential that we change this worldview from animal consciousness to human consciousness, so that we bring human consciousness back to our lives. And also, you know, we have to make sure that our relationships are guided by the right understanding. They are understood, they are fulfilled. So these two fronts human beings have to consider, where they have to give the appropriate place to physical facility, and they have to understand their relationships and feel that they are getting fulfilled. Now, you know, it can conducted by making change into our lifestyles. We can design our lifestyles appropriately. We can assess the need of physical facility properly. Then we can bring the suitable methods of production which is going to adopt these needs of people-friendly and eco-friendly manner of living. Then appropriate value education inputs also are going to facilitate this process of self-exploration. And this is how this transformation towards human consciousness at a mass scale can be initiated. So this is what we have learned till now. So how this transformation to human consciousness and universal human order is going to brought into our lives? So here the education system is going to have this major responsibility for preparing people and developing it into a living model of humane society. So earlier our focus was on this. We in the last point we have seen that we want to focus from animal conscious to human consciousness. So what is this animal consciousness? Animal consciousness was just about focusing on physical facility, and thereby the human are getting into this chain of reactions where it was leading to deprivation because not able to have this fulfillment feeling within. So because of that deprivation, exploitation and depriving others was happening, because rightly understanding relationship was not taking place, unhappiness was there, and also we were making others unhappy. So this was creating this inhumane society, which is based on assumptions in every human being. The assumption is money is everything. Then by few individuals, accumulation was happening by any means. So that was leading to domination and exploitation and fear in the society. And in the nature, getting mastery and exploitation of nature was taking place. Now this was leading to obsession for consumption, for profit, for sensual pleasures at the individual level and at the level of few individuals. Now in the society, there was terrorism and war because of this, and at the level of nature, resource depletion, and pollution is taking place. This is what is the current scenario. So the society is individual based, and they are having different goals or opposing goals. But if we talk about this transformation and the progress in the right direction, we can understand that by placing the right understanding at the first place, relationships and physical facilities are properly evaluated. The society is based on trust. There is mutual happiness and mutual prosperity among the people. So, in this humane society, there is right understanding and right feeling in every individual. There is prosperity in every family. Fearlessness, that is, the society is based on trust, and there is coexistence, that is, mutual fulfillment in the nature and whole existence. So this is the example of family based society, where families are having common goal. So how this transformation is going to take place? So with the help of humane education, with the help of value-based education, this is going to happen. We are going to prepare people, we are going to develop a living model of humane society. So this transformation to human consciousness and universal human order, there is a program of action at the level of society. So that we have understood. Okay, so human education sanskar is required to develop people with human consciousness. These people are going to participate to develop and maintain the harmony in the society. And in such a society, human education sanskar is available to every child. So we are going to start from the individual, then family, and there the aim is to reach to the world family. So this is how fulfillment of human goal can take place, where there is existence understood by all the levels. That existence is coexistence. So parents and teachers and policy makers are going to understand this, and that is how in education and sanskar program for children, that is going to bring the change. So how we are going to start for it? So the first thing which we have to understand is that we have to appreciate this need for self exploration. So up to this point, we should be adequately convinced about the need for carrying out the self-exploration. We should understand that there is really the need to analyze what we presently are and what we really want to be. And continuously we have to find out that this is what we really want to, and we have to change our actions accordingly. There is need to verify our beliefs and preconditionings, the need to understand what is motivating our actions presently and what its consequences are. So that also has to be evaluated continuously. So getting ready for self-exploration is thus the vital step towards the transition to this holistic way of life. So how we are going to do it? So we are going to facilitate this understanding of harmony at various levels. So to have the access to the ways and means to facilitate this process of self-exploration towards the right understanding. To have, it is necessary that we have this proper framework of understanding so that we can discover the harmony at various levels, starting from our own self and then spanning it up to the entire existence. It is essential that we give due priority to education, you know, which will be essential to make this available thing, that the required space for this essential input in the present curricula. So there is a need that this contents are given proper space in the present curricula, and also it is needed that sufficient effort and resources are devoted here so that it can be implemented successfully. So the efficacy of value education will be judged on the basis of the transformation achieved in the ethos, that is, on the basis of the clarity gained in discovering harmony and coexistence at various levels of existence, and the competence to live in accordance with this understanding in our day-to-day life. So if it is going to bring change to our lives, then we can, you know, be sure that yes, we are going into the right direction. So that judgment of that is possible. We can evaluate our methods, we can continuously judge it. And the example of some of the universities which I had shared with you in the first session of this class, that I would like to revise, where it was observed after introducing this kind of course into the universities, the students were, you know, better helping themselves to get placed, you know, but that was happening because of right understanding. The aim has been now completely changed from getting the job only for earning physical facilities, but the intention has been changed to that we want to do it because that is going to bring some harmony at the human lives. So that is how that can be evaluated. The efficacy can be continuously evaluated. So what are the steps for it? So that we are going to discuss in the next session. Thank you.